We are looking forward to this, thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished fans and colleagues, it is a great privilege for me to stand up here in front of you and talk things that some of you know better than I do, and some things that you will learn with a joint interest, so and beneficial will be the patient that we are all here for. Before talking about the presentation itself, I would like to share with you that in the world there are two kinds of presentations. One of them we call them ex cathedra, which means the speaker talks and the rest of you listen at the best case scenario. In some cases, some of you listen, some of you sleep. In some cases, some chat and put posts and likes. I'm going to do the first version. I'm going to do it together with you. I try to involve you as much as I can. And in addition, I would encourage you to stop me whenever you feel like it and ask questions immediately. Or at the end, you will also definitely have time for questions and answers. Today, we're going to talk about initially the introduction. Where am I, where I'm coming from, and why I'm here. What is laser? Things that the physicist, a word that is so close to physician, because physician, which is us, healthcare providers, we use physics in healthcare providing procedures. Evolution of dentistry, laser evolution, usage in dentistry, legal considerations, conclusions, and quotes. Before starting, I would like really to raise a question that jointly we will answer at the end of the session. Do we actually need lasers in the dentistry? Remember this, and that together we will answer at the end of the session, hopefully. Did you know that I'm coming from Kosovo, which is the newest country in Europe? This is the monument in front of the capital of Pristina, and it has old flags. Should be the Hungarian flag somewhere as well. But this is the way how we appreciate the international community and the way how they helped us and how we should help others in all fields. It is located in the Balkan Peninsula. We are a very small country, about 11,000 kilometers square. We've got less than 2 million of inhabitants. And the religion in Kosovo is mainly Muslim, Catholic, and Orthodox, which is not same as in other countries. In Kosovo, being a Muslim doesn't mean that you fast, you don't drink alcohol, you don't eat pork. Me as a Muslim, the best friend of mine is a Catholic, and they come at my house for our religion celebrations, and they bring us wine. And we celebrate together. That means that in Kosovo, every religion celebrates together, which is good. Going from the religion to the population of Kosovo, this is a chart which shows that we have probably the equal number of male and female, and majority is young. Why is this relevant with lasers in dentistry? Because we don't foresee a lot of treatments in 95 years old people. We can't use lasers, they have no teeth, basically. So the usage should be applicable in majority of population. This chart shows that we have about 4,000 employees in healthcare institutions with higher education. With upper secondary, we have about twice as much, whilst non-professional associates like the support staff, the drivers, are about 1,500. Now, these are licensed private clinics in Kosovo. As you can see, we have different polyclinics, about 60 of them, gynecological about 88, I'm talking about the entire Kosovo. Pediatric 49 and so on and so forth, but dental ambulances, dental clinics, we have a about as much as all other healthcare institutions in Kosovo. Which, again, brings the reason why Langevis has decided to invite Lazer's dentistry speaker instead of any other professions. Because in Kosovo, we really have lots of dental clinics. In addition to the previous chart, this is the, it shows the source of the, as well. In Kosovo, we have 1.2 healthcare professionals per 1,000 population. And different countries like Bulgaria, 3.7, Czech Republic, 3.6, and so on and so forth, all the way to Montenegro, which has 2.1. The average in the EU is 3.2, which gives you the indication that if you want to get sick, go to Bulgaria. That's the best place to get sick because the possibility and probability to get a healthcare provider very quickly is quite high in Bulgaria. Because you may struggle to find one. Another chart, the source is National Institute of Public Health of Kosovo, shows services in primary health care. We can see in 2006 we have about 1 million checkups. These are just people to doctors say, I'm not feeling well, they mark it down and you go home. About 3 million, less than 3 million in 2015, while the dental services is again quite high and increasing. Which means either we are not brushing teeth properly, or we are detecting oral diseases earlier. So it would be one or the other. In the Ministry of Health, we have set some objectives. Several of them. Two of them are relevant. Maintaining and improving of health. This is the objective of the Ministry of Health, referring to Kosovo. And objective three is reorganization of the health sector. So those two objectives are relevant with Lazer's. So if we want to maintain and improve health, we have to improve, provide provision of services and reorganization of the health sector. The most or the worst sentence is when you youngsters, I presume that you are younger than me, although we are quite similar age, when you come as a newcomer in the old institution in front of me, and you come with new ideas, new techniques, and the response usually is, who are you? I've done this all the time this way and I am not going to change it. So, it is our role to change things. Actually, it's your role to change and improve us and yourself. What is Lazer actually? Now I'm going into waters that I don't know well for myself. Because as we were talking with the previous speaker, physicists talk numbers. We talk actually what we do. What is the difference? My colleague said earlier that we use 400 and some nanometers and 2.5 picoseconds. You cannot convince me if I grab the tool and start cutting. He said, I don't know numbers, but this thing doesn't work. Or, very well done, again I don't know numbers, but this thing works. When you talk to the physicist talk numbers all the time, those curves. But when the tool comes to a clinic, we want to simplify things. Program one, soft tissues. Program two, dental or teeth. Program three, and so on and so forth. So we tend not to remember things that you find very important. We find important not to do or commit any mistake. So that's the difference between me, actually us as healthcare providers, and you as physicists. Going back to the slide, in your language, laser is a device that generates an intense beam of coherent monochromatic light, other than this is your language. In my language, it would be a device that produces a very narrow, highly concentrated beam of light. This is how doctors speak. Earlier in my life, I used to say that IT programmers, they speak English. We speak English. But we don't speak common language. Now, I understood that there are physicists as well. They speak English, same as IT programmers, same as healthcare providers, but we don't understand each other. So there are different type of words and things that we use, but we all have the same goal, which is patient and patient safety. So, abbreviation, it was said millions of times in this course, I'm not going to go through that, but for us, it's a device that produces very narrow light. What is light actually? Light is a source of power. It has its own energy. You know that, same as I do. You guys divide it into two groups, incoherent light and coherent light. Am I wrong? All right.
Yes.
I'm doing fine so far. What is the difference? Incoherent light, it gets spread. The coherent light, it's tiny. And to show this, or to distinguish this, I have brought with myself a torch. What does it do? Light show. And you can make it wider as much as you want, but you cannot make it smaller as it can be done. You use lenses to make it smaller, but you cannot make it smaller than this. Is that good? Is that bad? This is used by police, and they do it wider when they want to check the thieves, but they cannot make it as smaller as this. This kind of light is being used in healthcare as well. When we work, we have it behind our head, and we work. The bad thing is that it makes shades, which is always in on our way, always. In surgery, they make, if I may use the joke, the light in the operation theater, they have beams all over the place and they are focused on the operation area. So when a surgeon works on this side, there is no shade. So they have many of those lights, you probably have seen them, focused at their working area. And the surgeon doesn't have shades, which is very important to have illuminated field of work. We dentists, we got used to work in these circumstances, and somehow we get around the light, so we have a bright working area and not shades. This is typical incoherent light. Why? Laser beam, again, two needles similar, both in the same shot, but it produces a different light. And this is what are we talking about. This produces very narrow, if we go to the previous slide, very narrow beam of light, which is and can be used in healthcare provision of services. Laser, we know all this, is being used in different fields of our life. In customer service, we have laser printers. Everybody has printed something. We have DVD and CD players. You see CD player. It is basically this one. If we have somebody who is very skilled and rotates this in a certain number, if you get somebody who reads the projection of this, you can identify what's on this CD burn. To stop you from bothering, it is a cyber shot, it is something like software produced by a company. Military and police. In military and police, imagine a military commander or somebody asking you to shoot there. That's how army works. You may shoot somewhere, but you don't know what's the real target that your supervisor is at. say, shoot this, you will have an idea, exact idea that it was a requirement to shoot this punch. Probably will be that. So it is for marking target in army and police. Usually with those speed tickets, they measure us how fast we drive based on the reflection and the delay time, which again, physicists know better than I do. In industry, it is used for cutting and welding, and in healthcare, dentistry and surgery. I don't know why this had to be divided, because in some areas of the world, they call us doctors of dental medicine, some call us doctors of dental surgery, so they call us surgeons as well. But anyhow, for didactic purposes, we're going to use it as it is in many books. In dentistry, same as in other fields, laser is meant to facilitate our work. Its precision is crucial. The reconciliation or healing phase is much shorter. And physical and psychological trauma is minimized, as it was said by previous speaker. Nobody likes dentists. I'll tell you a secret. We don't like dentists. I said that earlier, this is during the coffee break, that the worst patient is a doctor. You are not the worst patient. When we sit on the dental chair, it's a nightmare. Especially in my case, because my wife fixed my teeth. So having a wife as a dentist is double trouble. This is the first dental unit. My colleague was happy when he purchased and started the business with this one. Afterwards, he improved. So, going back to the chalk, the traditional way of the healthcare services, the dental services, were improved. This is a complete dental unit. You've got the drilling bit that you had to spin it by your foot. You have the water supply, you have the water exit supply, you have very comfortable dental chair, and this is dentist seat. So dentist started to sit long time ago, to sit long time ago. This is my colleague doing a tooth extraction, very useful, done properly at that time. Another colleague of mine with his assistant. Now this one is more advanced. This one is more advanced. He's got two assistants to keep the patient still, which is, again, very important in our job. We don't like patients when they move around. And they move a lot because they are stressed. It is not pleasant to sit on a dental chair, even if you don't expect any dental treatment. The atmosphere inside makes you stress. The heart starts beating faster. So, as an advanced dentist, he's got two assistants. Probably this nurse here was announced as the nurse of the year because she's doing well. And again, my colleague doing a tooth extraction work, I presume. A beautiful line that I caught the other day, but I amended it. It said, 50 years of experience was needed to become a good beginner. I changed it because I felt so old saying 50 years of experience. I said 30 years of experience was needed to realize that I have to start new things. In other words, I call this evolution. Mankind evolved. Mankind from the beginning until today changed a lot. Got improved, got evolved. And same as dentistry. So from the previous dental clinics, we became in something like this. Unfortunately, this is not my clinic, I would love to, but it was nice. Same as my colleague and her assistant, making the patient comfortable, which is crucial in providing services, I presume that there is a movie going on here or TV serial, because patients don't like to miss their favorite TV serials. I don't know why. Their priority, and then dental treatment. And another client, which is located somewhere in the world. These many images were downloaded by from the internet. They were not protected by rights, so I presume it was all right for me to share them with you. Same as dentistry, the lasers evolved. I used to have a professor who called an old friend, so I'm going to quote him. My friend Albert Einstein lays the foundations of laser technology. Then other theories were presented. In 1950s, I'm not going to go into this because you know better than I do. Again, Columbia University graduate student proposes that stimulated emission can be used to amplify light. So this is all evolution of laser technology. CO2 lasers developed in 1963. This is before I was born. I'm not that old. And we come to the summary of laser evolution. When it was conceived, when it was demonstrated, pumping method proposed, and so on and so forth. In 1960, I'm not going to read all of this because I know that you read better than I do in English. But it is a summary of evolution of laser technology during decades. So the previous slide was 1960s, this one is 1970s, 1980s, 1990s. And again, if I'm mistaken in all those presentations, you have to forgive me because all this data was collected on the internet. I am not the guy who does the history of laser evolution. Maybe you know these better than I do. Maybe in your universities that you have a respective subject who teaches you about the evolution of the laser. In 2010, this is now a new time, Dr. Charles, whose work on stimulated emission led to creation of lasers and enabled the photonics industry, he unfortunately died at age 99. He lived quite a long life. I just presume that this is the first laser ever invented. Again, if I'm mistaken, forgive me. It looks very posh. It looks very expensive. And from my point of view, it looks huge. I cannot imagine myself cutting a teeth with it or a tissue with it. I presume that it will be very heavy. I presume it will be very expensive, because in our life we do calculations a lot. I buy a device, this amount of money, I divide by this much of patients that I treat during the year, and I'll get the money back in this time, and then I will start benefiting after this period of time. If I bought this laser at that time, it would take me centuries to get my money back. And first of all, it was governmental property. I don't think that they would sell it to me as a dentist. Lasers today are completely different. They are cheaper, they are faster, they are more precise, and more useful. The word useful is the key word in entire this thing, because it is useful. Which gives me the faith, gives me the hope that you physicists will make it even better. You will improve it even more and make our life easier. I hope that you will. Or will you? You're sleeping? No. This slide was presented by the previous speaker. How does the laser work? The laser is directed to the affected area, which contains more water molecules, and it pops. They explode. When you use the word explosion, it sounds like those military activities. No, they're like a popcorn. It's a nice explosion. And those molecules, when they get heated rapidly, they explode. And what's the best part of it? The laser kills any bacteria, which is a different area. What is the difference between us and surgeons? I keep saying, me as a dentist and a surgeon. Dentists would love to have working area same as surgeons do. Let's give you an example. A surgeon, before entering the operation theater, they demand from nurses, go and prepare the patient. Means what? The operation room has to be disinfected. The patient should be disinfected, the working area. They use one-use covers, they use single-use scalpels, how you call them, and everything is sterile, no bacteria at all. So they open the patient, they do the job, they close it, they go home, and then somebody cleans after them. This is ordinary, typical working day of a surgeon. In dentistry, it's slightly different. We work in the environment with millions of bacteria. Whatever we do, the tissue, soft tissue, the root canal, the extraction of the tooth, that's microsurgery. We open wide doors, because when you extract the tooth, you have blood here, you have wide open door to the bacteria which are always there, spread on your face and body, and you give the opportunity to the bacteria to enter the human system and get infected. Luckily, it doesn't happen often. But imagine a scalpel when you cut the soft tissue, which is usually infected, because that's why you are cutting in the first place. You are opening the way to the bacteria which are present to enter. You cannot sterilize the mouth. You cannot. People tried it before, it didn't work, so they stopped, they gave up. By using lasers, first of all, the cut is more precise. In our language, you call it clear cut. The line is beautiful because the area which is swollen, when you use the blade, you don't get the result as you wish. But when using the scalpel, the laser, you have the cut that you always wanted. And by cutting, the laser kills bacteria in the affected area. In addition, it closes, by coagulation, it closes this bleeding, so it makes the operational field visible, which again makes our life more easier. The best book ever published is First, Do Not Harm, or To Err is Human. Sorry. To Err is Human. We all do mistakes. I recommend you, everybody who wants and wishes to work in healthcare in any angle, go to this book because it took the courage of a doctor to stand up in front of everybody and say, guys, I did a mistake. And he published a book. After he saying that, everybody stood up and told their mistakes. And by sharing mistakes, the probability of repetition of the same mistake gets smaller. That's the aim of the game. As we said, why lasers in dentistry? The cutting is faster with minimum power, thanks to, again, numbers, 445 nanometers, maybe more, maybe less. These data were collected on the internet. The result in treatment is minimized thermal damage and increased efficiency. Instead of working 45 minutes, we do the job in 15 minutes. Shorter time, the better result. What did I do now? It can be used for a variety of treatment of soft tissues, which were said, but you can go through all of these as the time goes. In addition, it can be used for single tooth whitening. And as a treatment option for a variety of indications. Why single tooth whitening on all teeth? Do you have any idea? Do we have dentists here? Why would we would prefer to use on single tooth whitening instead of all teeth?
Do you mean internal whitening?
In dentistry.
Internal or external?
Internal. Non-right. The single tooth whitening process is, first of all, easier. Second, you cannot go wrong. Why is that tooth discolored? Because probably earlier one of my colleagues or our colleagues had done the pultectomy or removed the pulp. That is a dead tooth with no nerve, no veins, no arteria, and by time it changes the color. And if you work on that tooth only, you cannot go wrong. It is already dead tooth and it's already black, and you try to get it to as close as possible to the neighboring tooth. When we do the old teeth whitening, we have some later reactions. Those teeth get kind of hypersensitive to some patients. That's why there are still clinical trials on process. We'll come back later to that. Patient is more comfort. Again, diode lasers, other lasers. I'm not going to go into that because you know that better than I do. But the diode laser operates at a wavelength which is absorbed by the soft tissue more efficiently, resulting in more precise cutting and faster healing by increasing the patient comfort. Nobody likes to sit in a dental chair. Usually they are afraid of that noise, spinning turbine, which is approximately 400,000 revolutions per minute, a lot. And by using lasers, first of all, you don't have the noise. Second, you have the feeling that the doctor knows what he's doing, the dentist in this case. So it's more reliable approach. Focus beam treats affected area efficiently in the last time limited we set this argument. Surgery lasers is almost bloodless, we mentioned this, because while cutting you close the bleeding and makes the procedure more efficient and reduces the time of healing. The healing period is much shorter. Now the repetition of the previous speaker, the periodontology, how can they be used? It is usually supplementary. It's addition to the old-fashioned periodontal cleaning. The dental scaling that was used and is still being used is conventional scaling. It uses ultrasound to remove the deposited whatever it is in the periodontological cases. But in addition, you can use lasers. In endodontics, my previous speaker started to talk about root canal. There are things that cannot be done by manual instruments. Simply cannot. And lasers are very, very useful in this case. I presume that you would know I'm not the best artist. Presume this is the crown, this is the root. And we have access with manual instruments only on this part from the root chamber to the pulp, from the pulp chamber to the root. But there are always some accessory, hardly visible by microscope, that with those instruments we cannot have access. That's why our treatment materials have to stay in channel up to 2 weeks. So by osmosis and they travel and kill bacteria here. But using laser, as the physicist explained, but entering here, the light will kill every possible bacteria which is in the affected tooth. And the end result is always much better. We spoke about the single tooth whitening. And now, lasers can be classified in various methods. By the lasing medium used, such as a gas laser, solid laser, and so on and so forth, according to range of wavelength, and of course, to the risk associated with laser application. CO2 laser wavelength has very high affinity for water, resulting in rapid soft tissue removal and hemostasis, which is very important and crucial in our field of work. Although it possesses the highest absorbance of any laser, the disadvantages of the CO2 laser are relatively large size and cost. If it's expensive, it's not good to us. You can talk about the laser as much as you wish. If we cannot afford it, I can just feel sorry for you and for us. The young wavelength is absorbed by the pigmented tissue. These things were covered by my previous colleague. I'm not going to go through that. But so you know where it's being used. I presume that this presentation will be shared by, for the students, so you can very easily read. You got my email address. If any question appears after 5 years, feel free to submit the question. If I'm alive, I will remember answers. I'm not that old. Diode laser. Do we want to talk about diode laser? This slide you've seen before. It is the iceberg thing. What people outside of this class see is a success. Yeah, a laser was invented, go for it. But behind that, there is a huge work people don't usually see. There are so many disappointments. Like guys in the lab trying to do it smaller as we requested, faster, more precise. There's a persistence, hard work, it's not easy at all. Huge risk, many labs exploded during their history. Late nights, struggles, competition, because we are doing hard work, but the competitor puts in the market faster, earlier. So entire work gets lost. Discipline, courage, doubts, criticism, failures, and sacrifices. It's not easy to be a scientist at all. And this, your presence, makes me a bit nervous, because I know and I expect from you a lot. And this summer, instead of some bathing somewhere, you have chosen to come here and learn things, which proves to me that you are committed and makes me very responsible in presenting whatever I know. Legal considerations. Always, it became a standard operational procedure. Whenever you treat a patient, you have to give him slash her a piece of paper that patient reads and agrees. It's called informed consent or signed consent. They have to agree. Every procedure is risky. I mean, if you want a guarantee, you go and buy a TV set. They fill a form and said in 2 years it will work fine. In healthcare operations or healthcare services, you have no guarantee. And the lasers, on top of other services that we provide, are slightly risky. That's why you have to have an informed consent, which means that the patient should be informed about the risk possible and agree about possible complications and consequences. Even conservative soft tissue surgery procedures, they have to go through the same procedures, so nothing new. Just continue the old work. A bit we will talk about this slide. You heard about medical tourism. For the same, I was talking with one of my colleagues, I know if in the class now, he did a crown in Canada. That's you. And another crown in
Jordan.
Same, I presume, same quality, completely different price. So we are talking here about same procedure in different countries. So heart bypass, it would cost you $123,000, whilst in India it would be about $8,000. Dental implant, as we are talking about dentistry here, in USA would cost you 2,500 euros, was the cheapest one is in Costa Rica, and I truly believe that there is a very good doctor dentist in Costa Rica that makes equal quality implant as the one in the United States. So what do people do now? They search where a good dentist in Costa Rica. They do a survey, they buy a ticket from the United States, $600, they go to Costa Rica, they make an implant, they visit Costa Rica, everybody would like to visit Costa Rica, I presume, and they come back. So they get the high class quality service, not only dental, all of them, they visit Costa Rica, they do some sunbathing, because there are nowadays some medical tourism agencies, as we used to go to the travel agency and buy a ticket to go to the summer holiday somewhere. Now you buy a ticket and the guy in the healthcare medical tourism agency, they can set an appointment for you, tell you the prices, and then set everything for you. So you just grab the luggage and off you go. Get the service, get everything. Conclusion of what was said. Laser technology for hard tissue application and soft tissue surgery is at high stage of refinement. So it is being refined all the time. And I hope, truly hope, that it will never stop. Having had several decades of development, up to the present time, and further improvements can occur. Actually, it may occur as we are talking. As we are speaking, people may develop and come to the market with others. The field of laser-based photochemical reactions hold great promise for additional applications, particularly for targeting the specific cells, pathogens, or molecules. Further area of the future growth is expected to be a combination of diagnostic and therapeutic laser, as my previous colleague said. Looking at the future, it is expected that specific laser technologies will become essential. They will become essential. And now a bit about laminates. What do they do? These people, you think that it's easy to sit on your chair. They think, no. These people organize public debates, involve the media, related to laser usage in different health-related issues. It is not himself or the lady in the back, but they include everybody with the same joint goal, to improve the patient. So they do the ticket arrangement, the meals, the transport, the zoo, everything.